This is the new double cock. It's three times as tanky as the prior iteration, it has no watches out requirements, and it's the build that I've been using to farm all the Uber content this league. And it's also what I'll be taking with me into the deepest depths of Delve. Path of Building isn't particularly useful for gauging the power of this build, but you can see already that I can face tank a flawless Chayula while killing it in a pretty reasonable time, you know, under 10 seconds. The thing is, the damage of this build scales with the difficulty of content, as all other corpse detonate dead, volatile dead builds do. And thus, it is, by design, handled to do uber content. There are, however, some zones that are particularly difficult, like Simulacrum, which is a monster level 75 and really doesn't have any monster life modifiers. It only has damage reduction. So in these zones, my build does a lot less damage and it just takes a while to kill the bosses. Offensively, I'm running two cast on critical strike setups. One of them is with Cyclone, Desecrate, and Detonate Dead, and the other one is using Anomalous Vengeance as an actual skill gem this time, along with Volatile Dead. I'm able to trigger the Vengeance through the use of Eye of Innocence and self-hit with Self-Ignite, and the self-igniting is enabled again through Replica Reckless Defense. The combination of these things, in addition to enabling Vengeance as a cast on crit trigger, also gives us Ash application from the Wrapped in Flames notable, Leech from Eye of Innocence, movement and attack speed from Hot-Headed, and a bunch of cast when damage triggers which give us both utility and more damage, and better recovery. The defenses of this build are mostly stolen from Darky. He's arguably the single best player in Path of Exile, full stop, so if you don't already know who he is, get informed. And he's currently farming for a similar build in solo Selfound Hardcore. And the key difference between our gear is actually the helmet, where he's using a Viridi's Veil, whereas I do not because I'm on softcore trade. As far as physical mitigation goes, I'm using Defiance Banner, Determination, the Smashing Strikes notable to give us Endurance charges, and Flasks. Now for elemental damage, I'm converting most of the elemental damage I take from hits into chaos damage through the Glorious Vanity jewel. But instead of using Doriani like I did in the past, this time I'm using Zabaqua, which converts 50% of the elemental damage you take into chaos damage. I'm also getting an additional 25% of elemental damage taken as chaos because of the use of Incandescent Heart. And this, in combination with a lot of additional chaos maximum resistances, gives us all the elemental mitigation that we need. Now as far as chaos mitigation goes, I have 90% chaos res. It's not a problem. This level of mitigation with the abuse of life gain on hit mechanics through the use of, for example, a Watcher's Eye, or life gain on hit on Shaper Rings, makes this build incredibly resilient while you're fighting things. The only vulnerability this build really has is physical or elemental degens when monsters aren't around to recover from. But even in these cases, this is better than your average build. What you end up with then is a really well-rounded character that can pretty much handle all the content in the game. But as per any corpse build, make sure your PC is actually strong enough to handle it before you start. It tanks my frames like crazy, even with all the upgrades. Even now, I'm only about halfway through my gearing progression, and I've already cleared all of the endgame content. This was all done prior to level 92, and I guess my big goal now is to push Delve as deep as I can with this thing. I'm gonna go through two things, the POV I would suggest following, and then my actual character, which is a completely deviant mess. In terms of constructing this efficiently, it's much more important that you understand how the build works rather than just knowing the inputs to this build, because there's actually a lot of possible gearing options you could go for. The short checklist for this build includes having crit cap, attack speed cap, overcapped chaos res, life gain on hit for spells, reduced cost of skills, the wrapped in flames notable, and multiple born of chaos notables. We'll go through the gem setup first because it's the easiest thing to do. I've already mentioned the two primary offensive links, but beyond this, one of the big cast when damage taken triggers is a bone offering, Aasmark, and ice golem. These are all going to be level 20. If you keep them too low, your mana costs are going to be way too high. The other cast when damage taken trigger is with Ball Lightning and Wave of Conviction, so this will give you a ton of recovery from Ball Lightning, and Wave of Conviction will apply exposure. Vol Molten Shell is also used here. I don't think that you should be using this randomly. I think you should be using this just to mitigate one-shots, so I've been using Molten Shell on Kosis, to tank Shaper Slams, things of that sort. Most of the damage in this game is actually fairly predictable, so I think that it's much better to have these tools available to you for when you want them, rather than relying on triggers. The aura setup is a Defiance Banner, Determination, Vitality, and Precision. You can level up the Vitality as high as you want, it doesn't really matter. I personally only use it because I have a Watcher's Eye for Vitality, but it's totally optional. And then finally, I have an Unset Ring holding a Wraith Spectre, and you really need these Spectres as Lithomancers and Stoneskin Flayers as with any corpse build. This will increase the average health of the corpses in whatever zone by X amount. You don't really know, it depends on what the zone actually looks like. Instead of a Martyr of Innocence, this time I'm recommending the use of a Replica Dust On. This lets you hit crit cap much more easily, and because now I'm realizing you should be using Anomalous Vengeance, which gives you cooldown recovery, I don't know if that 7th link is actually that much more beneficial. Either way, these two stabs are fairly comparable, though Martyr of Innocence is stronger at the low end, whereas Replica Dusk Dawn has higher top-end scaling. Devouring Diadem has been put in since, just to deal with the mana cost of things. I was running with the Mana Flask for quite a long time, but I really wanted to drop it so I get one more defensive flask. An Incandescent Heart takes our chest piece. Although other options are available, I think this is just the best defensive one. And then an Eye of Innocence is the last core unique. I'm anointing Undertaker on here because I don't path over there on the tree, it's just too inefficient now. Everything else is rare, it's mostly focused on accuracy, chaos resistance, and max life. The flask setup is flexible, but I think you should be valuing defensive flasks on this build. Forbidden Taste is actually really valuable in particular, especially when you have the trigger on Savage Hit enchantment. You have so much chaos res that the degen is completely negligible. The clusters are where things get interesting, and where you have a lot more decisions. So remember that checklist we had? Well, you can get things on a lot of different jewels. The large clusters are totally flexible, and it's one of the reasons why I opt for our voices. So this looks a bit scary, but a 5 socket voices is like 25 chaos this league. It's super cheap to get. The mediums too are fairly flexible. I'm going for mostly crit mediums. I do, however, have one fire damage over time medium, and this is giving me Wrapped in Flame, which lets you apply Ash all the time. I don't think the fire mastery for Ash is that consistent. You always want to pair this with Clicked Alive, because there aren't really other good medium notables on the fire damage over time cluster. Quick Getaway is probably my notable choice. This build tends to lack movement speed. With Tailwind and Elusive and Elevated Onslaught boots, you hit around 200% increased move speed, which is pretty good. But you'll find that you have quite a bit of pressure, especially to find enough chaos resistance on this build to be going for those kind of boots. It will be ultimately the high-end upgrade though. Your small clusters, however, aren't exactly negotiable. You really, really want to get Born of Chaos. This is what's giving you elemental mitigation and more chaos mitigation. And three of these will bring your maximum chaos res in combination with this Glorious Vanity giving you Divine Flesh to 89% chaos resistance, which is huge for mitigation. Every additional node you get is even better. And finally, there's one more chaos notable that gives Anti-Venom, which will get you to a clean 90%. I think it's also possible to get +1 maximum chaos res on Glorious Vanity on some of these small notables, but I'm not too sure, and I'm definitely not going to recommend that you go fishing for that. I recommend one Thread of Hope here. It's not super core, but it does give you some efficiencies and saves nodes on a tree that is really starved for nodes. The annoying thing about this tree is that almost everything on it is mandatory, and the only thing that's not mandatory are life nodes. In other words, you don't really get to have your life nodes until the very end of the build to really round up that tankiness. The mastery choices are fairly flexible, but I really would recommend going for the Elemental Damage Leech SES on this setup. Even though you have really good energy shield recharge rate with Devouring Diadem, when you're tanking a big pack of mobs, your cast when damage taken triggers will be popping all the fucking time. And because of that, you'll really want to have some form of ES Leech to help mitigate your mana costs. This is an import of my actual character, and it's a bit of an abomination. I'm using two voices instead of 1+1 large, and I'm using 3 megalomaniacs. I was using 5, so all these megalomaniacs cost me Utter and Exalt, most of them are under 50c. But they're pretty cool, because you can look for a bunch of useful mods for this build. So this one, for example, has Born of Chaos. It's got Corrosive Elements, letting me drop Wave Conviction and put in one more skill gem. And then I also have Graceful Execution, helping me reach both crit and accuracy cap. So in short, I'm using these megalomaniacs to get rid of the use of small cluster jewels and instead be able to use Born of Chaos on my medium cluster jewels. All it really does is save me nodes. The downside though is that you don't get this really valuable small notable. Another sample one pairs Born of Chaos with Wrapped in Flame, and then I have one down here with Anti-Venom, Max Life, and Force Multiplier. This is the final notable that's giving me 90% chaos res. Each additional maximum chaos res you go for makes you substantially more tanky. Although I know people that will stop at 83, or 86, or 89. I personally just go for the cap. In addition to this, something else you might not be able to get is a Watcher's Eye with these two mods. So the Vitality Life Gain on Hit lets me relieve pressure on my rings to get Life Gain on Hit from your spells, and this mod is actually really good. The reduced crit damage from Determination helps me drop Viridia's Veil without any worries. I know a lot of people are just playing soft core, so they won't really care anyway, but this, in combination with this Incandescent Heart, which I picked up for 3 exalts, already 6 linked, gives me crit immunity. That doesn't mean I don't take any damage from crit strikes, it means I don't take any extra damage from critical strikes. I also had Mr. Khan run me a Devouring Diadem with Vengeance. Love you, man. And then I'm getting stun immunity on my boots through a Synthesis Implicit, and this cost me 1 exalt. Obviously, I don't know how much this gear will be available. Having flexibility in terms of how you look to build this is going to be really important if you don't want to waste a ton of currency. Finally, I think this gain flash charge on a critical strike on your Hunter belt is really, really valuable. I actually prefer having this to Headhunter. Let me know what you guys think about this iteration. In one sense, it's more difficult to gear than the old double cock. You need to look for much more res on your rares. You need to be much more precise with how you build your clusters. On the other hand, it doesn't require a 50 exalt Watcher's Eye. So that in and of itself makes this much cheaper. Regardless of cost though, this is just way tankier. But honestly, as far as my experience goes, two cocks has never felt so good.